Before you read, this is a story about a thoughtful and loving son. He works hard to fulfill his parents' wishes and gets some unexpected help. Taro's rewards. A young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. One evening when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. It whistled through the cracks of the hut and everyone felt very cold. Suddenly, Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of shake. It would warm me and do my old heart good." This made Taro sadder. Then, ever for the heart warming drink called shake was very expensive. "How do I earn more money?" he asked himself. "How do I get a little shake for my poor old father?" He decided to work harder than before. Next morning, Taro jumped out of bed earlier than usual and made his way to the forest. He chopped and cut as the sun climbed, and soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. "My poor old father," he thought, "if only he was as warm as." And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the shake to warm the old man's bones. Then suddenly Taro stopped chopping. What was that sound he heard? Could it possibly be rushing water? Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in that part of the forest. He was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of the sound. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. Kneeling at a place where the water flowed quietly, he chopped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. Was it water or was it sake? He tasted it again, and always it was the delicious sake instead of cold water. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. The old man was delighted with the sake. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall, thanking them for the delicious drink. She left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found, to his great surprise, all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again, and then shouted angrily, "Water! Nothing but water!" Others also tried, but there was no sake, only cold water. "We have been tricked!" shouted the villagers. "Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." But Taro had been wise enough to sleep behind a rock when he saw how things were going. He was nowhere to be found. Muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the sake a dream? Once मोर ही कॉट ए लिटल लिक्विड इन हिज हैंड एंड पुट इट टू हिज लिप्स इट वाज द सेम फाइन सेक टू द थॉटफुल सन द मैजिक वाटरफॉल गेव द डिलीशियस सेक टू एवरीवन एल्स इट गेव ओनली कोल्ड वाटर द स्टोरी ऑफ तारो एंड हिज मैजिक वाटरफॉल रीच्ड द एम्परर ऑफ जापान ही सेंड फॉर द यंग वुडकटर एंड रिवार्डेड हिम विद 20 पीसेज ऑफ गोल्ड फॉर हैविंग बीन सो गुड एंड काइंड देन ही नेम्ड द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल फाउंटेन इन द सिटी आफ्टर तारो दिस सैड द एम्परर वाज टू एनकरेज ऑल चिल्ड्रन टू ऑनर एंड ओबे देयर पेरेंट्स। हरीश जीएसपीएल 31 सेवा संस्था के सुजनने से एजुकेट इंडिया। Our aim is to educate everyone in a simplified manner through self-study books. These books improve your reading, pronunciation, and translation skills.